After 6 months of teaching a select group of entrepreneurs about the most important word in business and seeing their success from it, I set up a secret gathering deep in the mountains of California to celebrate their new lives. They were just your average everyday people who had a massive desire to create freedom and create something valuable for the world. They were dog walkers, chemical engineers, college students, shy, awkward developers, and entrepreneurs still stuck exchanging time for money. But before we get into that, I have a question for you. Do you know what the most important word for success in entrepreneurship is? Without this word, you jump from idea to idea, only to fail and jump again. Without this word, you have no clue what to do next, and without this word, you're in a constant state of fear and anxiety. Now, this word has nothing to do with any woo-woo or feel-good words like desire, persistence, or hustle. It's real and it's concrete. It's the one word that all of us crave, but only a few have mastered. And the folks who have mastered it are rewarded over and over and over again, while those that don't are left with little or nothing but a frustrated desire they will likely never fulfill. And if you're still trying to guess the word, it isn't freedom either. Now, before I share this word with you, let's take a sneak peek at three of the smartest, most sought out, and well-respected entrepreneurs in the world who are using this word to shift their businesses right now. Let's look at Tim Ferriss, author of The 4-Hour Workweek, an amazing dude who built a multi-million dollar supplement company, sold it, and is now investing his money into software companies because of this one word. Or how about Jason Fried, another one of my idols, owner of 37 Signals. Jason shifted his business from designing websites and logos to building software products. Why? Because he craved more of this one word. Or have you ever heard of Mark Andreessen? The dude's a billionaire. He's the secret weapon of Silicon Valley, sitting on the boards of Facebook and eBay and many others. He recently created a venture capital company to invest solely in software, all because of this one word. So, what's this one word? Have you figured it out yet? The word is predictability. Software is the ultimate tool for creating predictability in business because it creates a steady, reliable stream of income every single month. And that's why the smartest entrepreneurs in the world are shifting towards software, because it's predictable revenue they can count on. But the most exciting part about software is that you don't have to be a celebrity, a tech genius, or a developer to get started. I'm just a guy in a small town from Iowa who started with none of these skills, just a burning desire to create freedom in my life. Now, I got into software 6 years ago, and I've created 7 different software products since. 4 of the 7 are currently profitable. Now, the most successful one is paperlesspipeline.com. Go check it out. It's currently doing around $40,000 a month and growing. Now, I didn't come up with the idea. I didn't write any of the code, and I built the first version in 8 weeks. I followed a predictable process to create it, and today, less than 2 years later, it's completely automated and I don't even touch it anymore. I'm free to focus on things I enjoy, like traveling the world and mentoring entrepreneurs. But sadly, I hear people who crave this lifestyle saying things like, I don't have an idea, I don't have loads of cash, I don't have time, or the most common, I don't know how to build software, I'm not a developer. But what if I told you that none of these things are true? And I can prove it. Now, over the last 6 months, I've worked privately with a select group of struggling entrepreneurs, just shattering these false beliefs. Now, this wasn't an easy group to get into. They had to apply, be accepted, and then live through the gauntlet. In 6 months, the group whittled from 224 down to 88, and finally down to 30. By following a predictable plan, they made more progress in 6 months than most people will in a few years. And finally, their success stories are ready to be told.
Sam, you said something earlier about downloading my brain and stealing it and keeping it or something.
I said I stole your mind and I'm not giving it back. And I'm going to supercharge it. I feel like you pretty much shared everything you knew about business. You shared it with us. And it was up to us whether we like took it in or not. I feel like I did and like maximized it. And now I'm only going to grow it more.
This is gonna be fucking fun. I imagine the energy in the room just kind of building as you guys start sharing like roundtable stuff.
Dane has created ridiculously optimistic people after the roundtable.
Dane always took the time to listen deeply and understand the problem that was blocking the next step.
I've always considered myself a hard worker, but then kind of getting in and being put in this environment where people were hustling harder than I was, that was pretty inspirational.
I started a career seminar series to bring in people that had a background in science to see what kind of jobs that they did.
And I brought in a whole bunch of people, and I realized that none of them were what I wanted for my life.
I think our first client has already paid for the first month, so.
He just gave us so much all the time, week after week. We got so much of his time, one-on-ones. Like, he was so accessible. From the first week or two, I think we had a cell phone number.
Mixergy on three. One, two, three.
Mixergy!
Like, you're not gonna be the same after this.
When you enter your email address, you're gonna meet Sam, a 22-year-old New Zealand native with no coding skills and no business idea. Sam built iPad software for property management companies. And in the first month of its release, he's already at $2,000 a month. And the best part is that because software has reoccurring revenue, this is the lowest his revenue's ever gonna be. He'll be at six figures within 12 months. Way to go, Sam. Or John, a hipster from New York, a 37-year-old graphic designer, guy wears nothing but plaid shirts, zero coding skills, who's now making scheduling software for music band managers. And get this, managers for musicians ranked in the top 10 in the world are lined up, anxiously awaiting its release. Or Troy, a family man on the West Coast, who in his spare time, between his wife, his baby boy, and running his full-time, very successful business, has built a product that generates $5,000 a month in revenue. Now, what started as a side project will likely be a primary source of revenue in the next few years. Or Saba, an ex-consultant for companies like Accenture. She created a predictable recurring revenue stream and launched with 18 paying naturopathic doctors in her first month without building any software at all. And I bet you'll never guess what her business is until you see it either. And while it's wonderful that they've made this amount of progress in such a short period of time, what means more to them is the fulfillment they feel from building something meaningful. They aren't doing sketchy internet marketing tactics to make a buck. They've created value by solving real-world problems that remove pain from people's lives. And they've built something they're proud to share with the world. Now, these are just a few examples, and I have many more to share. But I don't want you to believe that angels came down from the heavens and magically blessed these entrepreneurs with businesses overnight, because that didn't happen. These entrepreneurs hustled relentlessly. They got rejected, knocked down, made fun of, yelled at, and were told no over and over and over again. It wasn't easy, but it was exhilarating. And in the end, the ones who persisted through the pain shifted their entire mindset, and their lives have completely changed because of it. I've documented their paths of toil and triumph for you. Their stories are going to help you in your journey of building a successful, profitable business that matches your future reality with the life you have pictured in your mind. Now, hearing their stories will help you predict what you need to do next. Enter your email to get a detailed, full-length case study of how Sam Ovens created his first profitable software company without any idea of what to build and without knowing how to write a single line of code, how he convinced 12 companies to buy his product before it existed, and how he reached his first $2,000 a month of recurring revenue within the first month of launching, all starting from nothing, in fact, just from a garage in New Zealand. Now, one word of caution. This case study explains why traditional business advice keeps you on the hamster wheel of failure. You'll discover counterintuitive business truths like why knowing how to write code actually hurts your business, why you're better off starting a business without an idea, and how you can start a business without raising money, but still have revenue to pay a developer so you don't have to give away equity. And if you're feeling skeptical, that's okay. Most people are until they see the case studies. When you see the truth that Sam now sees, a whole new world of possibility will open up that you never even knew existed. And who knows, maybe next time I launch a roundtable, it'll be your story that I'm sharing. Enter your email address and you'll see how Sam was able to predict the success of his business before he ever started building a product, and how you can do the same. I'm looking forward to meeting you on the inside. I'll see you soon.
Welcome to the good life. Welcome to the good life.
The wait is over.
Welcome to the good life.
All I gotta say is,
welcome to the good life.
You're welcome. You're all welcome. Like we always do at this time, I go for mine.